All right, I'm out here at First Energy Park in Lakewood, New Jersey, speaking with Marlon Anderson. Marlon, you're now the hitting coach here with the Hagerstown Suns, and the Suns have been in control of the Northern Division for much of the first half. It's getting pretty close down to the wire now. Just talk about, you know, what do you think the keys to the club's success have been this year?
We just got a good group of guys. You know, they're baseball knowledge hungry. They love to play the game, and they compete every night, and that's all you really can ask. You know, I think all of them still learn to. A lot of first-year, full-season guys, and, you know, they're learning the routine and how to do it for 140 games, which sometimes can be tough, but they've been pretty good so far.
Now, you mentioned the team's good. Now, I've seen the team play a few times here as they visit Lakewood in Jersey. You know, it seems like a good vibe in the clubhouse, seems like a good vibe in the dugout. You know, what do you attribute to that? Do you think it starts with the coaching staff?
Well, I think the coaching staff is always made up. You look good by the players you have, or you look bad by the players you have. I can't say how much. Like, so we just got a good group of guys. They get along real well. They love playing the game. They love being together. It's just, you know, they're making a journey together. That's what the minor league is about, is making new friends and playing baseball and just learning the game and learning the schedule, learning the situation all together. It's a lot of fun because you got guys that just enjoy it so much and love being at the ballpark and in the cage.
So you mentioned coaches look good by the performances of the players. Particularly you have a prospect that's well-regarded, highly regarded as one of the best going. Now, I'm sure this could be a question that you get fairly often. Does that sort of thing make your job easier or change your approach at all?
No, it definitely doesn't change your approach. It's my first year doing it, too, so I'm trying to figure out what my approach is. And it's about relationships with all of them, you know. You build a relationships, and I'm not here to change anybody, anything they do or whatever. I'm trying to get the best out of their ability and, you know, make, you know, little you know, tweaks here and there on things that they may do that may not be right, but we're definitely not reinventing the wheel here. You know, all the guys, they've been hitting for a long time. You know, Bryce has been swinging the bat well for years now, and you're not going to change anything. You just hope to enhance what they have and, you know, help build their confidence in what they do.
You talked about developing your strategy or your methods overall. You're not that far removed from your playing days yourself. Do you think that kind of helps you bond with these guys?
I hope so. I think it definitely doesn't hurt that, you know, they know I've been on the field not long ago. But I think it's still, if you can just come off the field and they can see right through you, if you don't have anything good to say, anything knowledgeable to say. And I just kind of like being out there, like trying to encourage the guys, keep them positive and believing in themselves and knowing that they can go out there and get the job done.
As far as your transition into coaching, at what point did you know that you would be a coach, and was the transition, has it been as easy or more difficult than you thought?
No, I've known for years. I always knew I'll eventually get back into gaming coach. And, you know, it's just one of those things that, you know, you either know you are or you know you're not. You know, some guys want to get back in and, you know, they take too much time off. I had an opportunity to get back in, and I felt like, you know, the best opportunity to just go ahead and take and get back in, get back involved, and, you know, just keep your name on the coaching circle.
Around these parts, you're probably best known for your time with the Phillies. And while there, you were managed by guys like Francona and Boa. Have you sampled from those guys or any other coaches as far as your training, your coaching methods go?
Well, I feel like I've played for a lot of great managers, a lot of good coaches. Like you say, Boa and Francona. And I had a fortune enough to play for Lou Piniella and Tony La Russa and Frank Robinson and Jerry Manuel and Willie Randolph. I think I've played for enough guys that have so much knowledge of the game. I think I take a little bit from everybody. I think you watch those guys and a lot of different methods to the madness, a lot of different things that all of them do. But, you know, you're eventually going to become your own person, your own coach, your own manager, whatever. But I think you always take a lot from the experiences that you've had from each one of them.
Obviously, you came up through the Philly system. But you never played here in Lakewood. Lakewood wasn't around back then. But do you have any special memories that stand out for you from your time in the Phillies developmental system?
I remember all the good coaches, all the good coordinators they had, from Ramona Vilas, you know, Bombard. I think they had Al LaBeouf for a long time. They had a good crew of guys that cared about the players and really tried to get the best out of you on the field and off the field. You know, help you stand up and be a man and take care of your business off the field as well as on the field.
And do you have any highlights or any memories that stand out from your days as a major league Philly?
No, of course. I mean, you know, my first at bat in big league, hitting the home run against the Mets, and it's just I can't begin to put all of them together. You know, they had a great time here, great career here. Just I enjoyed the experience of learning how to be a major leaguer and just being involved with the team and just the community, all of it. It was a good experience for me, and like all the people there are always great to me. So no complaints. I just appreciate all the opportunities I ever got.
Coach Marlon Anderson, thank you so much for taking the time.
No problem.